My name is David Shallery. Most know me as Batman. You know, this David, if you follow me on IG. I love cooking. Today we're gonna just be doing a three-course meal. Gonna be avocado pasta for the first, you know, the main course. Second gonna be a stuffed chicken breast with cilantro and garlic lime pasta. And then the third one is actually going to be a bourbon salmon with sauteed asparagus and some steamed broccoli. And so our first dish that we're gonna do is actually the avocado pasta, which you're gonna need one ripe avocado, about a half of a fresh lime. You're gonna juice it. I just, you know, squeeze it right on top. You're gonna need about a quarter cup of the chopped cilantro, about a half a teaspoon of cumin, half a teaspoon of garlic powder, and a half a cup of buttermilk, and, you know, of course, a little bit of salt and pepper to season to your taste. Pasta is not really rocket science. You just, you know, you bring a pot of water to boil, and you just, you know, once it's boiling, throw your pasta in. You can do all of this while, you know, you're doing your dressing as well too. Don't wash the pasta. You don't have to drain it, just boil it. All your ingredients for the dressing, just go ahead and what I normally do, I just pulse it every now and then just to start it off. You could just set this right in the refrigerator, just let it set a little bit until your pasta is done boiling. Alright, so what we're doing now, pasta is done boiling. You go ahead and get a colanda or a strainer, whatever you want to call it. Put your pasta in there. Put your pasta in there, you're good. And what you actually want to do is get very cold water and just rinse your pasta with it. Now with the actual avocado that you're going to dice, like as an extra ingredient in the pasta, this one could be a little bit more firm. But when you're making a dressing, you want that avocado a lot more softer. Alright, so with your pasta, your diced avocados, you'll put the lime in before or after, it really don't matter. Squeeze a half a lime on there. So when your diced avocados, take your dressing, pour it in. Grab a couple of cherry tomatoes, grape tomatoes. You could even use regular tomatoes. You're just gonna have to do a lot more cutting with it. And I don't do much. What you do next, pretty much the last step, you just give it a light toss. You don't want to mix it in, you just give it a light little mix, toss it in. And once this is done, you go ahead and you just refrigerate it for about an hour until it's ready to serve. But yeah. Doing is just for the second dish, like I said, it's gonna be actually a spinach and feta cheese stuffed chicken breast. And pretty much what we have here, we have some Italian pasta, cilantro, like I said, I love it, some green onions, some assorted sweet peppers, one red onion. This has nothing to do with it, this is just for my salad, and you know, regular onion, clove, garlic, and little bit of seasoning salt. I'm from the island, so I use adobo. That's like, I don't know, I just call it magic. It just makes everything taste good. So, there we go. We're just chopping up our ingredients here. Like I said, we're doing the stuffed chicken breast again. All the ingredients you chop up, you just throw it in. You could do a little bit or all at a time, really don't matter. Just let it sit. You could just use your hand, just mix it up. And you set this in the fridge for about 10-15 minutes, let all the flavors just, you know, mix up and just soak into each other. Let the chicken soak up all of this stuff. Now is, like I said, we're doing the stuffed baked chicken, which is right here, you know, marinated in the seasonings and stuff. I'm gonna actually make the sauce for the chicken right now, which you use about a half a stick of butter, about a clove of garlic, about a quarter piece of onion. You could chop it. I like it real small, so I'm gonna just chop it real small here real quick. Clove of garlic. Squeeze of a lime. You don't even have to do like your whole lime, just a little. Just to get that extra flavor. Watch it right here. You put it on the stove. Medium high heat. And you put about, I want to say, just about a little over a tablespoon of olive oil in here. You just saute this over medium high heat. Once the butter melts, then you just bring it down to a low heat, let it simmer a little bit, and let it simmer for about 10-15 minutes. So the actual pasta is already boiled. I boiled it with a little bit of cilantro, a little pour of olive oil, just so it don't stick together. So man, the aroma is crazy. This is basically the sauce now. It's just starting to boil out. You can just smell the aroma of the garlic in there. It's amazing. One more ingredient I put in this, I don't know, y'all could probably guess what it is. Favorite ingredient in the world to cook with. It's a little pinch of cilantro, because cilantro is already in the seasoning for anything else. So, just to give it that extra little pop. Not a whole bunch, because the whole point of the cheese is for spinach and feta, but I just like to add a little bit more mountain of flavor in there. And you take your cheese, put your cheese in there, kind of tuck it towards the back so you have this front space to go ahead and work with. You know me, throw it in there. What I do is I pretty much you seal in it. So you got all this wonderful yumminess in here. Got your peppers, your feta cheese, your little aged cheddar. You seal that up real good. And what I do is I just close it with this. One down. Chicken breast. It's gonna be good. What I normally do, I take some of the excess seasoning, put that around there. Let all that yumminess just kill it. Just so you know, it'll get that quick little cook, and then I turn it down to 300, 295 sometimes, because like I said, you don't want the chicken to get too dry and too hard. You want it to kind of stay moist in there. You could also cut about a quarter stick of butter and just put it around the chicken in it, just so when it melts it creates a little bit extra gravy. The chicken, as you know, is not really going to chop off its own water. So like I said, 350 to start off. Once it's heated to 350, put it in there for about 10-15 minutes, then you lower the heat to about 290. For time purposes, I had already pre-seasoned my salmon. What I use is some fresh lime, ginger, bourbon, brown sugar, and another ingredient or two that I'll just keep to myself. Y'all could figure out what y'all want to do, season it to y'all taste. About to go ahead and saute the asparagus now. No special thing, just a little bit of olive oil. You could dash a little salt, pepper on there. Boom, and there you have it. So this is the avocado pasta. This is the grilled bourbon salmon with the sauteed asparagus. We have the steamed broccoli and the cilantro garlic pasta with the spinach and feta cheese stuffed chicken breast. So give me 1 second here. Go ahead and get this for you guys. And there you have it, you know, my 3-course meal here. Thank you so much for joining me, spending this time with me on my first episode here. Definitely gonna have more to come. Y'all have a wonderful day out there. God bless.